Daddy, we pray you minister to us this evening in the mighty name of Jesus. Speak to us and speak through us in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I pray God will bless us in Jesus' name. Please, can we have our seats? And I want to celebrate the host. And I pray the grace of the Lord will not depart from my life in Jesus' name. Reverend Stephen, I honor you, sir. Thank you for the privilege, for being around you. It's a privilege. Mommy, you are welcome. The Lord will bless us in Jesus' name. Please, can you do me a favor? Just let us have our seats. Please, let's have our seats. My spirit have issue with roaming around if I'm under administration. Please, let's just settle down. All you just need to do if you're under the ministration of a teacher is to concentrate. If you're under the ministration of a prophet, you can connect. But if you're under the ministration of a teacher, let your mind be here. Don't let your mind be in heaven. Let your mind be what? Be here. Because the best way to receive a message from the mouth of a teacher is to let your mind just be in the place where the teacher is ministering. That's why I want you to just do me a favor, pay attention. And I pray God will bless us in the mighty name of Jesus. Without wasting much of our time, we just go quickly to the message and I title it Doing Business with the Spirit. Doing Business with the Spirit. Please, the moderator, I need the time. How many minutes I'm having? Just write it in the paper so that I will not just go astray. I need the time. John chapter 14. Verses 16 to 17, and I read. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it sees him not, neither know him. But ye know him, for he dwelleth with you, and he shall be with you. This is a popular Bible verse. But there is a certain dimension of revelation I want to release through this teaching that will be of benefit to every one of us that have the understanding that one of the purposes why you are saved is to serve heaven. Pay attention. The first understanding I want to drop into your spirit now is that the moment you are born again, the call of God is upon your life. I repeat. Pay attention. The moment you are born again, the call of God is upon your life. You don't need a prophet to tell you that the call of God is upon your life. One of the best way to know that you have assignment on earth is that you are saved. Somebody shout hallelujah. Salvation is the criteria to know that you are called by God. We are going somewhere doing business with the Spirit. Because I want to show you the importance of doing business with the Spirit as long as you are living on this mortal earth. You will see the reason why many are frustrated even though the salvation of God is upon their heart. You will see the reason why many are confused, why they are trying to work this out and things are not working for them, simply because they neglected a certain dimension of personality that eternity has released to do business with, which is who? Which is who? The person of the Spirit. I repeat again. Salvation is a mark that you are called by God. You are not saved primarily to make heaven. You are saved primarily to serve heaven. Are you hearing me over there? I repeat again. You are not saved primarily to make heaven. You are saved primarily to what? To serve heaven. Can't emotion the getting distracted. I still have issue with those who are roaming about. Please, what is the reasons? Let everybody sit down, please. I beg of you. Let every activities be stopped. The few minutes I'm having, if you can just pay attention to it, your life will never remain the same again. I do say it, any knowledge you get today is a deliverance of future problem. The problem you are having today is as a result of yesterday's ignorance. Apostle, I don't know what I said to you, sir. I repeat again. Whatever problem you are having today is as a result of yesterday's ignorance. If you can get a certain dimension of revelation and understanding today, you are getting a deliverance from a future problem. So that's why when you have an avenue to gather together, where opportunity for next message or knowledge to be released is an avenue you should not take for granted. So let everything that is causing distraction die by fire. Saying that is like saying, I left order coming to this place. And I get it and I say, Daddy, my primary goal is to go back home. Apostle, I didn't know. I came here for a purpose. It is once I fulfill that purpose that I can be thinking of going back where. So it is when I finish my assignment on earth that I can be thinking of heaven. I'm not going anywhere now. I am not saved to make heaven primarily. I am saved to serve heaven. So it is when I serve faithfully and I am coming to the end where I knew that I'm coming to the end of my assignment, I can be thinking of heaven. So if you know that you are saved here, I'm using this opportunity to tell you that the call of God is what? Is upon your life. So salvation is a tool to know that you are called. Gift is not an avenue to know. Gift is not the criteria to know the call of God is upon your life. Gift is a criteria to know the area of your calling. If I'm talking to you, shout hallelujah. That gift in your life is not a tool to know you are called. It's a tool to know the area of your what? Of your calling. So salvation is a tool to know you are called. Gift is a tool to know the area of your calling. Anointing is a tool to know you are sent. So not everyone that are called are sent by God. And that is what we want to talk about tonight. That is the dimension of area we want to focus upon tonight. I want to open your understanding to know that you are called by God. That is not the criteria that you are sent by God. That you are chosen by God. That is not the criteria that you are sent by God. Salvation is a sign that you are called. Gift is a sign that you have been chosen. Anointing is a sign that you are sent. Is a product of predestination. Your choosing is a product of grace. Your sending is a product of alignment.